Hi, in this tutorial I will give an overview of Python integration with LabVIEW. Before we start, I will just introduce some of my Python resources. This tutorial is part of the Python for Software Development textbook. In addition to the textbook, I have made lots of videos and other resources. These resources are available on my webpage. In addition to Python for Software Development, I have made other Python resources and Python textbooks, Python Programming, Python for Science and Engineering, and Python for Control Engineering. All these resources, including the textbooks, are available from my webpage. So let's start with this tutorial. I will shortly give an overview of Python, LabVIEW, and how you can use the Python palette in LabVIEW, and I will provide examples in Python and LabVIEW. It is recommended that you know how to write modules and functions in Python. If not, take a closer look at one of my previous tutorial and video, Create Functions with Python. So Python is a fairly old programming language. This was created in 1991, and it's old compared to other programming languages like C#, Java, etc. But during the last 10 years, Python has become very popular, and today Python is probably one of the most used programming languages today. And one of the advantages is the cross-platform, and it's free to use. So Python can be used on all platforms, Windows, macOS, and Linux distributions. And it is free to use. And Python is also highly extendable because there exist hundreds or probably thousands of different Python packages or libraries that you can install and use in combination with Python. So here you see a basic Python example. Here I have used the Spider editor, which is part of the Anaconda distribution. So if you want to install Python, the Anaconda distribution is a good starting point. Because with the Anaconda distribution, you get, in addition to Python itself, you get lots of these additional packages or libraries included. LabVIEW. LabVIEW is quite different from Python. LabVIEW is a graphical programming language, and it has powerful features for simulations, control, and DAC applications. But LabVIEW is a fully functional programming language and can be used for many different kinds of applications. And now it's also possible to integrate languages like MATLAB and Python into the LabVIEW environment. If you want to learn more about LabVIEW, take a close look at some of my resources at my webpage. So here you see just a basic LabVIEW example. A LabVIEW consists of a graphical user interface called the front panel, where you create your graphical user interface by inserting so-called controls and indicators. And here you have the code, which is called the block diagram in LabVIEW. Here you wire your code. So you insert different kind of functions, and you have different variables, you have constants, and you wire those together using the wire tool in LabVIEW. And when your program is finished, you can just click on the run button in order to execute the program. So here you see the Python palette, which we are going to use in this tutorial. This palette is the palette and the functions inside are used to integrate Python code into your LabVIEW program. So you open a Python session where you specify which Python code you are going to use and the name of the function. And then you execute the function with the Python node, and then you can close the Python session with this function. So in this tutorial, I will provide the following example. I will create two functions in Python. The The first function should convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit, and the second function should convert from Fahrenheit to Celsius. So I will implement these two functions in Python, and then I will integrate these Python functions in my LabVIEW application. So here you see the Python code. So I'm going to create a so-called Python module. I will name it Fahrenheit.py. And then inside that module, I will create two Python functions. One function that convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit using this formula, which is stated here. And then the second function converting from Celsius, from Fahrenheit to Celsius, implementing this formula, which is this formula. So let's implement these two functions in Python. So now I'm in my Python environment. I'm using the spider editor, which is part of the Anaconda distribution. So let's just create this Python application. So I start by saving my Python file. I just find a location on my hard drive. So I name this file, I just name it Fahrenheit.py. Like this, save it, and then I start creating the code. So let's create these two functions. I use the def keyword in order to create a function in Python. So the first function called Celsius to Fahrenheit, and the input to this function is this Celsius value. Colon, and then let's create the formula TF equals to TC multiplied by 9 divided by 5 plus 32, like this. And then we return TF like this. So that's the function for converting from Celsius to Fahrenheit. Let's create the second function, def Fahrenheit to Celsius, and the input to this function is the TF, the Fahrenheit value. And then TC will then be equal to TF minus 32 multiplied with 5 divided by 9. Like this. So that's the formula. And then we let just return TC like this. So basically, that's the two functions. So let's just save this code. And now we should test these functions to make sure that they are working as expected. So I create a new Python script. I start by inserting these functions into my code. So I use from Fahrenheit import these functions C2F, comma, and F2C like this. Then I just set TC equals to 0. And then I want to find TF, and then I use this function C2F, and the input to this function will be then TC like this. And then I can print TF like this. So let's just run this code and see what's happening. I can just save it first, and I save test functions or something. Like this, and then let's run this code. And as you see here, the input value was TC equal to 0 degrees Celsius, and the output was 32 degrees Fahrenheit. So we have used this function in order to convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit. Let's do the same, the opposite way. Just copy it, change this to df, and let's use value 32, and then TC equals to Fahrenheit to Celsius, like this, and input is TF, and then we print TC. So let's just run it. And as you see, the first one was when TC equals to zero, that Fahrenheit value is 32 degrees, and when TF is equal to 32, the Celsius value is zero. So you see that the functions we have implemented in Python is working as expected. So let's go to LabVIEW and see how we can integrate these functions in a LabVIEW application. So now I've started my LabVIEW programming environment. So here in the startup window, I just select File, New VI, and then this LabVIEW windows appearing. This white one is this block diagram where we create the LabVIEW code, and this gray one is called the front panel where we create the graphical user interface. So now we should start by creating this create two numeric controls. Let's start with this. So now we want to start using the first function, converting from Celsius to Fahrenheit. So then we have this TC, like this. So then we can enter a Celsius value here. And then in addition, we need to create a numeric indicator, which is this TF value. So we are going to convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit, like this. So this is our graphical user interface. We can save it. So let's save it in the same location as the Python application. So you can call it convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit. And the name of the LabVIEW application is called, or the file extension is called .vi for virtual instruments. So now we have created the LabVIEW application, convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit, and we just save it. And this, if you go to the file explorer now, we see we have this LabVIEW application here, convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit. And this file consists of the front panel and the block diagram. So let's start creating the block diagram. So we are going to convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit. Next, we need to find these Python functions. So just right click here in the block diagram, and then the functions palette is appearing. So then we need to find this Python palette. So we find it here under connectivity, Python, and then we have these Python functions here in the Python palette. So we can click on this pin, and then we can have it here open all the time. So let's start using this open Python session. So here is those. We can also right click here, view as icon. And you see that these are numeric double values. And also you can right click here, select visible items and label. So we can also click Control H. Then you see this small help window. So this function has an input for Python version. So let's just right click on this input, create a constant, and here we can type 3.7, which is my Python version. I can also right click here and visible items and labels. So now we have defined which Python version we are going to use. So that's this open session. Let's go to this Python node. And you see here, this has a session in and a session out. And also here, it has a session out. So we just wire this one to the session in like this. And then we need to have the module path. So we just right click here, create a constant, and then we get this path constant, and we have our Python code here in this location. So I just copy the path like this and paste it inside this path constant. And visible items label. So this is the module path. So this is where LabVIEW finds the Python module in this location. So next is this function name. So I right click here, create constant, and the name of the function. If you go back to our Python code, so this is the name of the function we are going to use. So the name of the function is just called C2F, like this. I just right click, visible item, and label. So this is the name of the function. So now we have the path to the Python module and the name of the function, which is inside this Python module. And next, the input to the function is the value in Celsius. And also here we need to specify return type. So I just go here, right click, go to numeric, and select a double numeric constant, like this. And wire this on. So this, in this way, Python or LabVIEW knows that the return type of this function should be a double. Next, we just make this bigger by pushing on it or clicking on it, and then we can just drag to get more inputs. So the next input should be this TC. So you just wire it like this. And the output should be the temperature in Fahrenheit. So you just wire it like this. And now we need to close the session using this close session function. And also we can right click here, visible items, label, and the same here. Then we wire this session like this. So now basically we should be finished. Just put it here in the upper corner. Save it and go to my front panel like this. And now the input here is 0, and then we should expect the TF to be 32. So let's just run this example. And as you see, now we get an error message because I have here in the module path, I have entered the path for the Python module, but I have not specified the name of the module. So I just copy this function inside here. Sorry, the name of the module. So so Fahrenheit.py like this, that's the name of the Python module. So now I can run my application. So let's just run it. Still some error. Yeah, it was of course a basic spelling mistake. this. Now I can run it. And as you see, TC equals to 0 gives TF equals to 32. I can try with another value. 30 degrees Celsius gives 86 degrees Fahrenheit. So now we see that our Python function is working and we have integrated the Python function in our LabVIEW application. So now we have created a LabVIEW application for converting from Celsius to Fahrenheit. Let's create a similar LabVIEW application for converting from Fahrenheit to Celsius. Then we can of course start from scratch, or I just prefer to just copy this one and rename it. Convert from Fahrenheit to Celsius, like this. Now I created this one, I can just open it. Now we have two LabVIEW applications. Then I just need to change some small parts here. So the module part is correct, Python version is correct. The name of the function here should be convert from Fahrenheit to Celsius. And then the input here should be TF, and the output should be TC. So Fahrenheit, Celsius. So basically that's it. So now we have these two functions. This one converts from Celsius to Fahrenheit, and this one, if I type 32 here, convert from Fahrenheit to Celsius. And you see 32 degrees Fahrenheit gives 0 degrees Celsius. Let's try with another value. 22 degrees Celsius gives 71.6 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's try 71.6 Fahrenheit gives 22 degrees Celsius. So now we have created this function that converts from Celsius to Fahrenheit using this C2F function which we have created in Python. And the second one is almost identical. It converts from Fahrenheit to Celsius using this F2C function which we have created in Python. So that's how you integrate your Python code in your LabVIEW applications. So that's all. If you want to learn more about Python and LabVIEW, you may take a closer look at my webpage. There you find all my Python resources and my LabVIEW resources. So that's all. So good luck with your Python programming and your LabVIEW programming. Thank you.